Hi viewers, welcome to all. Here we are discussing about your project multiplier free implementations of Galois field Fourier transforms on FPGA. The symbol from a vector representation to a power representation by NQ technique to performing the Galois field Fourier transforms is given that fully removes the requirement for a finite field multipliers. On recent FPGA implementations with a considerable quality of on-chip distributed embedded memory, the proposed approach of this work to design a Galois field Fourier transforms with a minimum number of logic gate to reduce the complexity in the FPGA implementations and increase the multiplier speed. For that, the proposed approach introduced a XOR MUX full adder design instead of conventional full adder design, and developed this approach with a serial in parallel out, parallel in serial out, and optimized serial in parallel out architectures, and compared all the parameters in terms of area, delay and power. Now we can verify the base paper. This is a base paper writer, base paper abstract. Here what they are doing means they are doing as a multiplier free implementations for Galois field Fourier transforms on FPGA. Okay, so here they are used to multiply the A into B multiplications. Further, they are given some Galois field 2 power n concept. Okay, so here they are used this algorithm method. Okay, so this is the addition process to multiply A and B. Okay, so here they are used the input to convert into the power representation to vector representation. After that, they are converted again the same method, the vector representation to power representation. Further, the technique, the multiplications will be happened as per the equations of Galois field method. Okay, so here they are used this method. This is a matrix of multiplications. Okay, so here matrix of multiplication means this is the output B0, B1, B2 and Bn minus 1. This is one of the input row, and this is a n size matrix. Okay, so this matrix multiplication means we need to multiply row into column. Okay, so as per that, they are given this B0, B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6. They are given this equation pattern A0, B0, A1, B0, A2, B0, A3, B0. Okay, as per this, but they are taken as a mod based number. Okay, n equal to 7. Okay, so based upon this n equal to 7, here the values will be changed. Okay, so we are drawn the Excel sheet work. Okay, here this is a row and this is a matrix. Okay, so as per this matrix, here they are used the, this is a first column and this is the first row. Okay, here they are used as a completely B0 and here also B0. Okay, in between they are used number of B1, B2, B3. Okay, all the things they are used here. Okay, so example, this is a B1, right? So how it will be B1 means here n minus 1 into n minus 1, here n equal to 7. Okay, so here n minus 1 into n minus 1 means 6 into 6. Okay, so you can calculate 6 into 6. Okay, 36 mod 7. Okay, the value is 1. Here they are used as a A6 B1. Okay, as per the calculations, they are given as a B1 value on here. Okay, and same as B5, B3, B1, whatever you was seen in the matrix table. Okay, so as per this equations 1, 2 and the flow of algorithm method, the computing GFT, the proposed architecture will be developed on here. Okay, the proposed architecture plan to multiply the AK into BZ. Okay, it's a calculation form. Okay, so this equations will help to design this architecture of serial in parallel out and parallel in serial out and optimized prime length serial in parallel out architecture. Okay, to reduce the critical path delay. Okay, so here the first architecture is serial in parallel out. Okay, so this architecture we are given as an input AK and BZ. Okay, so the BZ contain a beta ROM single port memory. Okay, and this AK value will given the address value to PROM single port. Okay, so this power ROM will have a represent value on here. This table one will help you. Okay, to convert the power representation to vector representation. So the same table, we need to convert vector representation to power representation, and it will have as a index ROM also will be available on the optimized prime length SIPO architecture. Okay, here it will be have as a index ROM single port. For this index ROM, we need to create a PROM table as per this method. Okay, the content of vector ROM and index ROM are as follows. Vector ROM equal to 1243675 and index ROM equal to 1243756. Okay, so as per this configurations, we are created as a table power 2 vector representation and vector 2 power representation and index ROM representation. Okay, so here this ROM memory we are created using Xilinx core library. It will support we are given as address means it will generate a data only. Okay, so this is a PROM configurations, beta ROM and power ROM and index ROM and vector ROM. Okay, so this is a code generated file. Okay, so here we are used the COE file to generate a PROM memory. Okay, so this is a file. Okay, so using this COE file we are generated this PROM memory configurations. Okay, so after this PROM generation we need to give an as an input to the wrap carry additions. Okay, so this wrap around carry additions we are used number of flooders on the existing part. The proposed part we need to develop a XRMUX flooder. Okay, it will reduce the number of logic gate in the wrap carry additions. Okay, so here the beta ROM single port we need to give as a input parallelly and AK value of PROM it will be come on serially. Okay, so here they are mentioned it. Okay, here in SI PO architecture inputs A0 to AN-1 come in serially. Okay, so as per this we are created the serial input on here. Okay, after this wrap additions we need to give a data to vector representation. So this vector representation will convert the value to power representation to vector representation. Okay, so here the first we are convert the input to power to vector and vector to power. Okay, so here after this conversion we'll get a multiplexer output. This multiplexer will checking the value it will be zero or non-zero value. Okay, if it is zero it will provide the output is zero only. If non-zero value it will provide the output the same to XOR gate. Okay, so XOR gate it's a mod function XOR gate. Okay, it will calculate the mod value with the output given as a input. It's a feedback output to input. Okay, so after that we will get the output of B0, B1, B2, B3 up to BN-1. Okay, so this same architecture part we are developed in the Verilog HDL coding. This is a test bench of the coding. Here we are given input sizes, clock, reset, address for AK to generate a PROM and beta ROM. Okay, and this is the output B0 to B6. Okay, and here we are used as a PROM, we are given as an address, and beta ROM here we are given as an address. It will generate the data and it will be given into the wraparound carry additions and vector ROM and multiplexer and XOR gate. Okay, so these are the supporting coding. Okay, and this is the simulation output of the single input parallel output method. Okay, this is the value. The final value is 6713114. Okay, and this is a beta ROM configurations and this is a wrap carry additions and this is a vector ROM. Okay, and this is a synthesis report of SIPO architecture. Okay, here it will be take a number of slice registers 21, a number of LUTs 42, occupied slices 23 and IO base equal to 26. Okay, and this is a RTL schematic. Okay, SIPO Galois field method. Okay, so here you can analyze the architecture. Here we are used there is address location to beta ROM and power ROM. This beta ROM will given the data to wraparound carry addition and the second input it will come from power ROM. Okay, so after this carry addition we are given the value to vector ROM. Okay, so this vector ROM output will be given to the multiplexers. Okay, and multiplexer output will given to the XOR gate and finally we'll get the output. Okay, and next architecture is the parallel in serial out method. Okay, so this architecture also the same, but we are given the value A0 to AN minus 1 as in parallel. Okay, so here this is a coding for PISO method. Okay, so here the A0 to A6 value we are given on here, and parallelly we are given as the address. Okay, and here the output we are taken only one bit. Okay, that is a BK bit. Okay, so as per this configurations we are given the value to power ROM, beta ROM and wrap around carry additions, and these are the supporting coding file. Okay, and this is a simulation output. Okay, so here the PISO output is 6452356. Okay, so if you move the cursor you can verify that. Okay, and this is a synthesis report of PISO. Okay, so here the number of slice register will take 32, occupied slice will take 14, IOB is equal to 28. Okay, and delay you can check on here, delay will take 5.471 nanoseconds. Okay, and you can check the RTL schematic. This is the parallel and serial out method. Okay, so here the same architecture, but the input come on parallelly and output went to serial. Okay, the same architecture method. Okay, and the third one is optimized method. Okay, optimized prime length SIPO architecture. Okay, so it will have a supporting index ROM method. Okay, so this coding will be developed on here, the same configuration, and this is the top module. Okay, so here we need to give us a separate AK input and K input and B0 to B6 output. Okay, because it's a output parallel. Okay, and this is an index ROM, and this is a wraparound carry additions and vector ROM and multiplexer. Okay, so this wraparound carry additions we are used as a XOR MUX full address. Okay, here this is a simulation output. Okay, you can check the final output, it's a parallel output, right? So you need to check on parallel. So 6560512, this is a output of this architecture. Okay, here all this architecture will provide the different output. Okay, it's not a same output because the architecture they are given with that. Okay, here the optimized serial and parallel output synthesis report given on here. Okay, number of slice registers equal to 21, LUT is equal to 42, and IOB is equal to 47, and the delay you can check it on here, 0.898 nanosecond, and you can check the RTL schematic. Okay, here we are given a AK value, K value and clock reset value and parallel output. Okay, so here you can check the architecture. Okay, wraparound carry addition for proposed thing we are used as a XOR MUX full adder. Okay, so this is the architecture of the XOR MUX full adder. Okay, and this is the comparison analysis for this all multiplayers. Okay, here we have developed the conventional full adder based architecture and XOR MUX full adder based architecture. The both architectures comparisons will be given on here with the SIPO, PISO and optimized SIPO architecture. Okay, so here we are compared slice registers, slice LUTs, occupied slices, number of IOBs, block RAM, maximum frequency, delay and power. Okay, so the comparison analysis chart will be given on here. Okay, and we have written an abstract document for this project. This is a title and base paper abstract. Improvement of this project, proposed title, proposed abstract, existing system, disadvantages, proposed system, advantages, introduction to VLSI with related notes, literature survey, finally references. Okay, this reference papers and additional reference papers we are attached in the folder. Okay, thank you.
If you need more video related with VLSI projects implementation, please like and subscribe this channel.